Morning students, today again we will start with our session. We have learnt about the current and its property, and last lecture we have studied the drift velocity. So drift velocity is very important part as your all problems are concerned, and for drift velocity, three relations I have given you. Those three relations are always important. What are those three relations that we will see? Well, first is Vd is equal to minus Ee upon m into tau. Second one will be your I is equal to Nea Vd. Or Vd is equal to I upon Nea. This one and this one. Also J is equal to I upon A. So J is equal to this upon A kya. So Nea Vd upon A. A will get cancelled and I will remain with J is equal to NEVD. That's all. That was all about the drift velocity. Now what happens? As we study the current electricity, in current electricity, there are two important things that I told you yesterday. We will start with that. That is, whenever the current flows through the conductor, there is an oppose for the flow of current. Whatever current is flowing, there is an oppose from the material inside the conductor, and that oppose is called as resistance of the conductor. What we can call it as resistance of the conductor. So today we will start with the new concept, that is resistance, Ohm's law and resistivity. These three are very important concepts, those which we are expected to study. So first of all, we'll start with first concept, that is called as resistance. Okay, so in order to study the resistance, we can generally consider a conductor. I know that up to your 10th class, you have studied everything about the resistance. What is that? What is its SI unit? Everything you know, that I know. But now, as we are in the higher classes, we are in the 12th class. Now, as per the 12th class is concerned, we are expected to go in the deep of this quantity and we will know how it comes. Actually, this Ohm's law is there. This Ohm's law, we will try to get the statement of Ohm's law from this. So let us start with that. Suppose this is a conductor of length L. Now apply the battery. That drift velocity, everything you are knowing that. And electric field is E. So if electric field is E and this is the length L, then you are knowing that the relation E is equal to minus dV by dr. This you can use directly. If V is the potential applied across the conductor, an electric field can be written as minus V upon L, where V is the potential. So we'll start with this. So let me again explain you. There is a conductor of length L. E be the electric field applied across its two ends. Suppose, of course, electron will be moving from here to here with a drift velocity Vd. And we will get a current I is equal to Nea into Vd. That's the same. No problem. Now what will happen? That we'll see. You just note down. So now this electric field is there. We are having our electric field, and we are also having the formula for drift velocity. So I'll start with the formula for drift velocity. Vd is equal to minus EE upon m into tau. Now I will try to use this formula, and in this formula I will put the value of E. Then what happens, that we will see. So my Vd will become minus E. Instead of capital E, I will put minus V by L. So I will put here minus V upon m into L into tau. So now this minus minus will get cancelled out, means minus minus it will become plus, and I will get EV upon ML into tau. So let me again explain the thing. So what is there? I am there starting with the conductor. I applied the electric field E. Electron is moving from this point to this point. Vd is its velocity, drift velocity. It can be given as minus EE upon m into tau. I in the conductor will be NEA into Vd. And the electric field can be explained in the form of minus dV by dr. Here we will not take r, but instead of r, we will take the L, and we will not take the differentiation, just we will take the ratio minus V upon L. Once we take this value we will put in this equation. In the for wherever E is there, we will put that value as minus V upon L. Once we put that value as minus V upon L, minus minus gets cancelled, and we get EV upon ML into tau. So this will become my VD. So let's go for next one. So for next one, we will start with the same. I will again write it, and then we'll go for the next. So just we studied about VD. VD was minus EE upon m into tau. Instead of capital E, that is the electric field, what I have just changed that, I have changed that capital E with minus V upon L, and I got Vd to be equal to minus E minus V, oh sorry, upon ML into tau. And lastly I got what? Vd is equal to EV upon ML into tau. That's all. Now what will happen? Now I am having I is equal to NEA VD. Toda, now we will try to put the value of I over here. So I can get I to be equal to NEA. Instead of VD, I will put EV upon ML into tau. So what I will get now? I will get NEE E square A V, okay, tau upon ML. So I will get somewhere the relation between I and V, where I is the current and V will be the potential. I is the current and V is the potential. So can I write I like this? Just see, I will be N square A tau upon ML into V. So this equation is very important. So again, let me explain you. We started with this E. We just put the value of V E over there. We got the equation for Vd. We put the value of Vd in the equation for I, and I got this equation. So that this equation is very important for you, because whatever is this quantity, which comes this total one, this quantity is constant. You may see n is the number of electrons, a is the charge on the electron, a is the area of cross section for the conductor, that will not change. Tau is the relaxation time, okay, that also not changing because we are taking it as a average time. M mass, L is length. So these all quantities are constant. So can I say that I is equal to some constant multiplied by V? So can I write I is proportional to V, and this one is actually your Ohm's law, actual Ohm's law. You may be call it as V is proportional to I, but actually if you are considering the proof of the Ohm's law, you have to keep in mind always, you have to write I proportional to V, not V proportional to I, because first we will calculate the current in the form of drift velocity, and we are getting this equation. That's why this equation is very important, that is I is equal to n square a tau upon ml into V, where this thing is constant. And इस चीज को हम बोलते हैं आर नहीं बोलने का, उसको बोलने का वन बाय आर, इसको बोलने का वन बाय आर. तो इससे मतलब क्या बनता है, वॉट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ आर, दैट वी विल सी नाउ. देन द वैल्यू ऑफ आर विल बिकम, वैल्यू ऑफ आर विल बिकम उल्टा, इसके उल्टा बन जाएगा एम एल अपॉन एन स्क्वायर ए टाउ. आर का वैल्यू कितना बन जाएगा, एम एल अपॉन एन स्क्वायर ए टाउ. सो दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज द रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द कंडक्टर. सो आर विल बिकम देन, इट इज वन अपॉन आर, सो इसका उल्टा करेंगे एम एल अपॉन एन स्क्वायर ए टा. तो ये बन गया अपना रेजिस्टेंस, और इसको बोलते हैं रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द कंडक्टर, और इससे मिलता है अपना ओम्स लॉ. तो इससे क्या बन जाता है, आई इज इक्वल टू वन बाय आर इंटू वी, और इससे बनता है अपना V is equal to I into R. Now you can call V is proportional to I. Already we have supposed this all. If you are knowing this, then you can call V is proportional to I. But at first, while deducing that, while deriving the equation, what we will start with? We will get the value of I as any AVD. VD ka value put karenge. VD का वैल्यू पुट करने के बाद जो पोटेंशियल है उसको बाजू करेंगे, और जो मिलता है एन स्क्वायर ए टाउ अपॉन एम एल, उसको बोलेंगे हम वन बाय आर, दैट इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट क्वांटिटी वन बाय आर. सो आई कैन से दैट आई इज इक्वल टू सम कॉन्स्टेंट इन टू वी, एंड आई विल गेट आई इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू वी. सो दिस वन इज योर ओम्स लॉ. सो वेन एवर द फिजिकल स्टेट ऑफ एनी कंडक्टर रिमेन्स द सेम, whenever physical state में क्या क्या आता है, length, area of cross section, material and temperature, because temperature का role होता है इसमें, अगर temperature बढ़ जाए घट जाए हम आगे देखने वाले हैं, उसका resistance change होता है. so whenever the all the factors means what, length, area of cross section, material, temperature are kept constant, then current in the conductor is always directly proportional to the potential difference. Okay, so can I state the Ohm's law? So what will be my statement? Just let me write on the board statement, Ohm's law. So what will be the statement? The Ohm's law statement will be, if the physical state of any conductor remains the same, the current through the conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across its two ends. So if the physical state of any conductor remains the same, the current through the conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across its two ends. And this is called as the statement of Ohm's law. Now what is meant by the physical state? I told physical state means either length, either not all. Length, baad mein area of cross section, or baad mein temperature or material bhi. अगर मटेरियल मटेरियल आप चेंज करोगे तो उसका रेजिस्टेंस चेंज हो जाएगा. द रेजिस्टेंस मे बी चेंजिंग फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर मटेरियल. सो फॉर फिजिकल स्टेट बीइंग कांस्टेंट, फर्स्ट इज लेंथ, सेकंड इज एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन, थर्ड इज टेम्परेचर एंड मटेरियल. ये जो अगर चार चीज़ें कांस्टेंट रहती है तो क्या होता है, इफ एनी फिजिकल स्टेट ऑफ एनी रिमेंस सेम, देन क्या होता है, द करंट थ्रू द कंडक्टर इज directly proportional to the potential difference applied across its two ends. So this was all about the theory and the history of the Ohm's law, actually how it was proved. So how we got the resistance, how the resistance term is coming, and from that resistance term how we can deduce the Ohm's law. So that was all about the Ohm's law. Now graphically, if you want to do these things, then what we can do, that we will see now, right now. If graphically अपन को निकालना है तो कैसे निकाल सकते हैं वो देखेंगे अभी. Graphically if you have to plot, so just you wrote V is equal to I into R. So if we'll plot the graph of V versus I, it will be a straight line, not necessarily passing through region. Whatever will be the value of I, depending on that you will start. So this will be your R, will be equal to slope. और उसका value कितना मिलेगा आपको, जैसा just हमने वो लिखा था, ml upon nea tau. So this is very important, because while calculating the another things, we have to keep the all the things in mind. थोड़ी यहाँ पे देखो, यहाँ पे आपका एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन आया, यहाँ पे एल आया. आर यू गेटिंग द पॉइंट? जो मैंने बोला था आपको, सो लॉन्ग एज द फिजिकल स्टेट ऑफ कंडक्टर रिमेंस द सेम, उसमें मैंने बोला था लेंथ और एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन. टेम्परेचर तो है, टेम्परेचर इसमें नहीं दिखाते, वो अलग सी चीज़ है, लेकिन ये दो चीज़ें इसके ऊपर ये आर डिपेंड करता है. तो आर विल बी द रेजिस्टेंस, उसका वैल्यू मिल गया अपन को एम एल अपॉन एनी ए टाउ. ये तो आपको इस साल पढ़ाया है ट्वेल्थ में, इसके पहले ये आपको नहीं था, क्योंकि पहले आपको ड्रिफ्ट वेलोसिटी का कंसेप्ट नहीं था, खाली आपको जस्ट उसका रेजिस्टेंस का फॉर्मूला और रेजिस्टेंस के प्रॉब्लम कैसे सॉल्व करते ये सब चीज़ें थी. बट फ्रॉम राइट नाउ यू हैव टू यूज दिस फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो. सो वी विल सी हाउ द थिंग्स आर देयर. फर्स्ट वी विल गो फॉर SI यूनिट. सो रेजिस्टेंस ये आपको सबको मालूम है, इसको मैं ज़्यादा टाइम नहीं ले रहा हूँ. रेजिस्टेंस इसका SI यूनिट आपका आएगा, SI यूनिट मिल जाएगा आपको ओहम. तो 1 ओम का डेफिनेशन कैसे कर देते हैं, 1 ओम विल बी V is equal to R I, so I I R, so R I R will be V upon I, so 1 volt upon 1 ampere. ये भी आपने 10th में पढ़ा है, तो इसका ज़्यादा पढ़ने का ज़रूरत नहीं है. 1 ohm will be 1 volt upon 1 ampere. So how we can define the 1 ohm of resistance? So we can define the 1 ohm of resistance as the resistance of a conductor is said to be 1 ohm. The resistance of a conductor is said to be 1 ohm if 1 ampere of current pass through its ends whenever a 1 volt of potential is applied across its two ends. So let me repeat, the resistance of a conductor is said to be 1 ohm if 1 ampere of current passes through it when we apply a potential of 1 volt across its two ends. Are you getting my point? Okay. तो ये हो गया 1 ohm का definition. तो और भी एक इसमें unit आता है, वो आता है किलो का. तो किलो का आएगा किलो ohm, मेगा ohm भी आता है, गीगा ohm भी आता है. तो किलो मतलब 10^3 ohm. Okay. मेगा का मतलब ज्यादा होगा 6, और गीगा का मतलब 9. तो ये ज्यादा हम यूज नहीं करते, ये किलो होम मेगा होम कभी कभी यूज करते हैं, लेकिन मोस्टली हम यूज करते समय किलो होम को यूज करते. 1 किलो होम इज 10^3 ओम. दैट ऑल वॉज अबाउट द रेजिस्टेंस. ये आपको सब मालूम है, इसलिए मैं ज्यादा इसके ऊपर आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू एम्फसाइज मच मोर इन डिटेल ऑन दिस. दिस यू आर नोइंग दैट, बट हाँ, I will suggest you to put a flash on this. R will be ml upon any a term. So I will call this here. So what I'll do, I'll again write that formula and make it as a VIMP. So एक बार फिर से आपको झलक देते हैं कैसे कैसे किया. पहले हमने क्या किया, E किया, E को माइनस V अपॉन एल डाला. बाद में हम VD किया, VD को क्या है और दिख नहीं रहा आपको, एक मिनट. VD को कैसे लिखा, ee अपॉन m इंटू टाउ. ये e का वैल्यू डाला, सब किया, तो अपन को क्या मिल गया, I इज इक्वल टू n e a टाउ अपॉन m l इंटू v, और इसको बोल दिया मैंने 1/r. तो मुझे मिल गया R इज इक्वल टू m l अपॉन n e a टाउ. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इसको नोट डाउन करो. This will be helping you solving many problems also, means not directly, but whenever we will go for studying the resistivity from this. So used to find definition of resistivity. तो resistivity का जो definition है वो find करने के लिए अपन को R यूजफुल होता है, विच इज एम एल अपॉन एन ई ए इंटू टाउ. सो इसको नोट डाउन करो. ओके, हो गया नोट डाउन. ओके, नाउ वी विल गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट थिंग विच इज कॉल्ड एज द रेजिस्टिविटी. तो यहां पे मैंने बताया आपको, ये आपका एल हो गया और ये आपका ए हो गया. तो पहले तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, नंबर वन, हम बोलेंगे इसको डिपेंडेंस ऑफ द रेजिस्टेंस ऑन डिफरेंट फैक्टर्स. व्हाट वी कैन कॉल इट एज डिपेंडेंस ऑफ द रेजिस्टेंस ऑन डिफरेंट फैक्टर. सो रेजिस्टेंस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू लेंथ. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, रेजिस्टेंस इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन. Resistance is proportional to length. Resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. इसका मतलब क्या है? ये जो बाकी जो चीज है, अगर मैंने ऐसे लिख दिया R is proportional to L upon A, इसका मतलब क्या आएगा? R is equal to some constant into L upon A. और ये जो कांस्टेंट है मतलब ये आपका जो बचा हुआ सब है, वॉट एवर इज रिमेनिंग, ये एम है, ये एनी है और ये टाउ है, बन गया, हो गया आपका। तो वो जो सब है वो आएगा एक कांस्टेंट, और उस कांस्टेंट को बोलते हैं रेजिस्टिविटी। उस कांस्टेंट को क्या बोलते हैं? रेजिस्टिविटी ऑफ द कंडक्टर। सो हाउ दैट रेजिस्टिविटी एंड एवरीथिंग कम्स, दैट वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो। थैंक्स अ लॉट।